Greetings from Indian Medical Association. I'm Dr. K.K. Agarwal, Honorary Secretary General, and with me is Dr. V.K. Moga, Dean-elect of IMA. And welcome to our weekly show on every Thursday, 3 to 4 p.m. And every week we pick up one subject, and the subject which we are choosing today is pollution. Why pollution? Because people have been saying that India is the most polluted city in country after China, and specifically the city of Delhi is the most polluted city in the world. When Obama came, people criticized that he should not visit India because he will be exposed to a very high air pollution levels. What are the effects of pollution level? What is pollution? How to measure? What is the role of medical community? What is the role of doctor? All these things we'll try to answer in the next 1 hour. And before that, let me, today's session will be moderated by Dr. V.K. Moga. And sure. I will be answering most of the queries.
Thank you, KK. Friends, today we are talking about pollution, and we have chosen this subject as a special one because of Delhi issues and Diwali issue. And you know, everybody has been talking all over the country on Diwali, this will be like this. And before that, I think we should give 3-5 minutes to IMS Satyagraha program that was planned for 16th of November, and with the initiative of our Secretary General and National President, they had a sitting, marathon sitting, and then series of meetings with the officials. And I'll request Dr. KK to tell you about what transpired in the meetings, what has been agreed upon, and what is our next course of action. Dr. Agarwal, please.
See, what happened was that ever since we took over, that is the interaction, Dr. Moga.
Yeah.
Ever since we took over, we had tried to have a series of meetings with the health minister. In some other forums, the president met Dr. Mr. Nadda twice, but there was no direct one-to-one meeting.
Correct.
And we have been asking for time. We did meet Health Secretary. We did meet Health Secretary twice. And we did meet
DGHS also. DGHS. Number of times, yes.
But nothing was moving. Mm-hmm. And the classical example is our RNDCP project, that's which right. is lying in limbo. And when I talk to the secretary, he says, I'm not aware. Mm-hmm. When I talk to the health minister, he says, I'm not aware.
In fact, they had promised that in October they will be starting again.
Even the April, from April it is not, it is lying to the extent that we said that are we begging for you for the project? We don't want. So enough is enough. So in the working committee we decided that 16th November we will have a IMA Satyagraha, not strike, as a protest. The purpose of this Satyagraha is the government listens to us.
Sure.
That was the basic agenda with that. So we decided making an agenda. We made around 10 points, and out of which we highlighted 5 points. Our 5 points are, we wanted a central act in violence. We wanted some amendments in PCP and DT. We wanted some amendments in Clinical Establishment Act. We wanted amendments in Consumer Protection Act and cross-party. So we started with Imagine Access. We started a signature campaign, which became success. More than 50,000 doctors committed to participate in the Satyagraha, the signature campaign. And this signature campaign was visible to everybody, including the politicians, because they were aware of that. In the meantime, we decided to have a webcast on email access of the Attorney General of India. My son Nilesh went to Mukul. He pursued him that he should come and give 1 hour address. And he came.
Yeah.
Which was live webcast to over 2 lakh doctors. And we posed 5 important issues with Mukul. The first thing we said was, what about central act of violence? He said, immediately, he said, you have 2 options. One is the government moves it.
Mm.
And second is you file a petition in the Supreme Court and ask for an interim decision. Pending legislation, but ultimately it will be a legislation, and legislation needs time. Only health ministry can initiate, but ultimately it has to go to the long registry also.
Okay.
Then we had in PCP and DT, we said we don't want any punishment for clerical errors.
Okay.
And we don't want non-pelvic address analysis to be under the domain. These are the two things we said. He says again it requires amendments.
In the Act.
In the Act.
Yeah.
Then he said capping of compensation and consumer requires amendment. Then he says Clinical Establishment Act, single clinic should not come.
That's right.
And accreditation should be by NABH and not by a CPA. He says again amendments are required. Then crosspathy, he says again amendments are required.
Hmm.
And it is not only amendment, this is interministerial amendments.
Hmm.
So we said, what is the answer? He said, you write to me. I will write to the Prime Minister to constitute a committee of Health Ministry, Law Ministry, Home Ministry, Consumer Ministry,
and group of ministries.
And IMA.
Yeah.
So he said, you do that.
Hmm.
This was the end. He said, that's the only answer. Then we asked him that, suppose the ministry agrees and they put down amendments, the amendment process may take 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. He says, at that particular moment, either you can pursue them to put an interim decision, or you can go to the Supreme Court for interim directions pending legislation.
Okay.
He says, both the options are available to you. So he says, don't worry about that. At the moment, your concern is that interministerial meeting. Normally, he says, if you go to the Health Ministry, they will pass a regulation. They will take 6 to 9 months. Then they will send it to
long process.
Law Ministry.
Yeah.
Law Ministry will set to Parliamentary Committee. He says it takes 2 years.
Correct.
2 to 3 years.
Bilkul.
So he says the best answer is that all the ministries and then in the meantime, we our letter had gone to Netaji that 16th is the Satyagraha if you don't fulfill our demands.
Mm-hmm.
So we were called. So National President, I went to meet him. Then he says, there is no demand which we cannot meet. And I told him, this is what we have discussed with the Attorney General. So I said, I must call my President. He says, you call.
Hmm.
Then he says, the President will have to wait, I don't know, because whichever time fixed in, I will give the time. So he called up, the office called up around 6:30 in the evening, we were waiting since morning. And he says, come at 7:30. So we went at 7:30 with the Health Secretary. And he says, agreed.
Okay.
He said, my family belongs to doctors. My sister is a doctor in Delhi, so I'm aware of all the problems.
Mm.
And I totally agree with you, but the system is like that. He says, what do you want? I said, we want a committee with minimum joint secretary level, so that they are decision makers, headed by additional secretary health, with a member from MCI, with two members of MCI, and minimum 3 members from
IMA.
IMA.
Sure.
So he said, MCI, 1 member is sufficient, because we are giving 1 member from each ministry.
Mm-hmm.
IMA will agree for 3 members.
Oh, that's great.
So now we have 3 members of IMA.
Mm-hmm.
Then he said, we want 3 months. I said, sorry, we will not agree.
Mm-hmm.
We give you 4 weeks. He says, how can it be possible in 4 weeks? The next week is off. There will be vacation. Saturday, Sunday, we don't work. So it is impossible in any government setup to have inter-departmental meeting to finish in 4 weeks. I said, maximum we can give you is 6 weeks, because it has to be before our central council meeting.
That's right.
I said, it cannot happen that another president takes over. I have no mandate. My mandate is I have to answer in central council. So he says, fine, that will be 6 weeks from now, from today. That means 10th from 6 weeks. That means it will be over before the central council. Then I said, you also will have to come and address the central council.
Okay.
He said, I will.
Good.
So he will come back and address the central council for half an hour. So that everybody is with him.
We have guessed the first hand information from his mouth.
What we wanted to get after Satyagraha, we could get it because of our signature campaign.
Yeah.
And a webcast from Mukul Rohtgi. Everything created impact. With that, we are postponing, not cancelling. Our preparations, our efforts will continue.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is 6 weeks. We are not going for rewriting of PCP and DT Act.
Yeah, you want modification?
No, we want only 2 things. In PCP and DT, we are only asking for 2 things.
Correct.
You may ask for 10 things,
mm-hmm.
but at the moment we are asking for 2 things, graded punishment and non-pelvic ultrasonologist to be out. In clinical establishments, we are only asking for a single clinic to be out, and we don't want accreditation by, we only want accreditation by NABH. If NABH is accrediting, why another accreditation?
Okay.
In consumer, we only want capping. Discussion on capping.
Sure.
In cross-pathy, we want the issue to be settled who can write
once
schedule.
For all.
Who can write schedule H, H1, X, and G drugs. We are not going into anything else. And in violence, we want a central right. So we have limited agenda, limited clear agenda to be finished in 6 weeks' time. We feel this is for the first time in the history of IMA. Therefore, IMA demands an interministerial committee has been formed. And the committee will decide only on the issues raised by IMA. And in 6 weeks, we should be able to get the answer. In any way, we have three members. We have three members of the IMA, which we feel, and there are intention by the government. They say there is nothing, there is no demand which is not feasible. He says only you have to find out is how to do it. So that's why. So therefore, we are postponing our dharna for another 6 weeks. But our efforts will continue. Our signature campaign will continue. We still want to cover 1 lakh people.
Okay.
So that by the time of 16th November, our campaign will be that kindly go on signing it so that at the 16th, now the 27th of Central Council, we want 1 lakh doctors in India, if our demands are not met, to take this petition for them.
That's right. I believe you must exhaust all your resources before you go for a satyagraha or a whatever strike or whatever you want to do. And I think it's a laudable effort by you people.
There are a couple of people who are not satisfied. Probably they were not clear that what do we want. What we wanted, we got it. After satyagraha, we only wanted this committee. Our satyagraha was not because
they couldn't
you cannot bring the ordinance in one day. We wanted a dialogue. This is a protest day for a dialogue. All those people who are talking about tolerance, they only want interference by the ministry. The ministry has interfered. The ministry has made a committee. We have got a letter. Now we have to proceed.
I think our unity and our pressure has worked.
Absolutely.
And then your meeting with Mukul Rohtgiji and the webcast, they all created an impression in the mind of the government.
So our special thanks
to
all the IMA leaders,
yeah.
all the past presidents, all the past secretaries, all the state and branch president secretaries. Special thanks to our coordinators. Tandon is there. Girish Vasta, who made all the posters. Then Dinesh Thakur is the one who is working. And then Vipin, who has been working. These are the group who people have been working.
Dr. Buller, I suppose.
Buller is there, who is working with us.
Yeah.
And my son Nilesh and Naina, who put down all their pressure in doing this. And everybody, and all of you. Everybody who are watching this program, it's a team IMA under the leadership of our national president, Dr. Vasantha Pillai.
I think credit goes to the team. And in fact, it is only a beginning. And once we keep talking to the ministers and everybody there in the office, we can definitely more results, better results for all times to come. It should be a definitely good beginning. I think you all need the congratulations for the same. But we have to be watchful because it is only a committee that has been formed, and the results, our action will depend upon the results we get from all these people. And we are hopeful because the government never wants to antagonize any of these influential groups, you know, doctors from influential group in the country. So I think it's a good job done, and membership should be applied to the leadership that they have done this job, good job. Thank you, KK. So we come back to the pollution issue, and the pollution, especially after Diwali, all over the country almost, is pretty bad. And once we talk about pollution, there are three types of pollution: air, water, and noise pollution. But we will restrict today to air and noise pollution in the aftermath of Diwali, because water, we have talked about it, and we'll keep talking about water pollution again in these programs henceforth. Dr. Agarwal, you are an expert. You are sitting in Delhi. Delhi is the most supposed to be the most polluted city in the world, and you have experienced this also. But can you, Amit, let us know what is the pollution level, what are the indexes in the country, and especially when we talk about Delhi?
Air pollution today is a reversible, modifiable risk factor for asthma as well as for atherosclerotic heart disease. Up till now, we have never linked pollution with heart disease.
Sure.
But now we know that air pollution causes atherosclerosis. We all are, every day we measure the temperature. You say, what is the temperature? Then we started measuring humidity. Now everybody says, what is the humid levels?
Yes.
Then there came heat index and cold index. People wanted to check, what is the heat index, what are my chances of getting heat stroke, and what are my chances of getting chills. So in winter, you start about cold index. So these index have started coming, and people have been started talking about. But nobody talks about air pollution index. This is called ARI, air respiratory index. Nobody talks about the respiratory index or the pollution index. But the time now has come to talk about it. Now the gadgets are available. Okay? You don't need to buy anything. You can go to your smartphone and you can download noise pollution gadget as well as
okay, that's good.
I'm going to show you.
Okay.
Say for example, if I am showing you the, you go to the webcast and I've gone to the global PM 2.5 gadget and it tells you the values.
Okay.
So it tells you the value.
That's right.
In Anand Vihar it is 596.
Can you focus?
In RK Puram it is 163 and in New Delhi US Embassy it is 195. It gives us a value.
It
gives us a value. It may not be clear. Air pollution index. You can go to air pollution index or ARI, air respiratory index, and see the value. Then you can find out the nearest place you are living. So you would know your value.
Good.
Now what does it measure? It will measure SO2. Sulfur dioxide, it will measure NO2, nitrogen dioxide, it will measure ozone, then it will measure particulate matters. Particulate matter can be 10 or particulate matter can be 2.5. 2.5 means particles, suspended particles of less than 2.5 micron. These are not visible.
Yeah.
And 10 means particulate matter with the size between 2.5 to 10. So that if the size is less than 2.5, these allergens will get absorbed in the blood.
Okay.
Once they absorb in the blood, they will cause damage to the
blood vessels.
So they will cause endothelial dysfunction, they will cause atherosclerosis, they can precipitate heart attack, they can precipitate stroke. So 2.5 is related to heart. But if the particle size is more than 2.5 and less than 10, it gets trapped in the lungs. So therefore it will cause damage to the lung parenchyma. So it will precipitate asthma, COPD, ultimately emphysema. So therefore PM 2.5 is linked to respiratory asthma and PM 10 is related to cardiac asthma and cardiac atherosclerosis.
Okay.
Now I want to measure it. So therefore I can measure PM 2.5, PM 10, okay,
yeah.
And then ozone levels, and then I have a choice, SO2 and NO2. All are available there. Okay. So in other countries, they measure PM10 and SO2, NO2. In India, we take concentration of 2.5, 10, NO2 and
CO2.
Ozone
and,
carbon monoxide levels. Now, all of them are measured in cubic millimeter. Microgram per cubic millimeter, except for ozone, which is milligram per cubic millimeter.
Okay.
Or milligram, that is microgram, mcg. Now, these values are calculated mean of full day.
Okay.
That is for most, except for ozone and CO, which is mean of 8 hours in India and hourly in the world.
Correct.
So the mean is available to you.
Okay. Yeah.
When the mean is available to you, you decide
What time you go out and what time
out of these five, whichever is the maximum is called the ARI index.
Okay.
Whichever is the maximum. So I'll give you a this is called air pollution index. Let's go to one side. They say RK Puram, it is 163.
API.
Embassy is 195. And Anand Vihar is 596.
Okay, Anand Vihar is maximum.
The normal value is, if it is 1250, 50.
Okay.
It has no health impact.
Okay.
Okay. If it is 51 to 100, it will cause discomfort in susceptible individuals. That means if the value is between 50 to 100, and if you are asthmatic, you may feel uncomfortable. If the value is between 100 to 200, it will precipitate asthma in susceptible individuals.
Okay.
If the value is between 200 to 300, it will cause a breathing difficulty even in non-asthmatics. Okay. If the value is between 300 to 400, it will lead to lung damage with prolonged exposure. That is reversible, not talking about irreversible damage.
Okay.
And if the value is 500 and above,
it as in Anand Vihar.
Anand Vihar. Therefore, at this moment in Anand Vihar, a normal healthy person, if he is going out, will feel cough. Will feel cough. I am coughing at this moment because I am suffering from sinus, therefore I am susceptible, and the value here is 163, therefore
very much
in patients with the breathing problem, it will cause breathing problem. I am already showing the results.
Okay.
So with the 400 to 500, it will lead to serious impact. That means at this moment, it is something like you say.
But it would have been worse yesterday night when there was all pollution.
We have to see the difference. Yes. I'll give you an example. When you say, I want to go to Anand Vihar, somebody says, it's raining, don't go. You don't go. Then somebody says, it's a huge traffic jam, you don't go.
You don't go.
But then nobody talks about there is a 596 pollution level. Don't go. So if you go with 596 pollution level, and if you are stuck in a pollution layer for 4 hours, it will cause some permanent lung damage.
Oh, God.
That's what I'm trying to say is, now let's what we do is, this is one site. Let's take another site. And he talks about is Amriki Dutavas, that means US Embassy. The PM 2.5 is 210.
And what are the normal values?
You always know there is a formula of 80 for Dr. KK. Okay. Here also you take it 80.
Okay.
Less than 80 is fine.
Okay.
And we have already said if it is 0 to 50 is good and 50 to 100 is in high risk individuals, it is bad. So the normal value is less than 50. But in India, less than 50 is not possible.
Let's take it 80.
Yeah. Remember, like everything is 80 as a formula. But the values are very high. Now the things which comes is, the most important thing is, that for every 10 microgram per cubic millimeter increase in pollution level, there is 1.5 times risk of asthma, heart attack and paralysis.
Look what? Every 10.
Every 10. Now imagine from 50, 60, 70, 80,
to 600.
600.
Oh, this is criminal, I think.
This is what I am trying to say. Therefore, what I am trying to say is 600, you can't even imagine. It is not 10 times.
Sure.
50 to 500 is not 10 times.
Every 10 you are talking
every
about.
Every 10 microgram will increase your chances by 1.5 times. Then, uska 1.5 times. So, therefore, pollution can be the number one cause of heart attack in the country. Now, pollution is of two types. Short-term exposure and long-term exposure. When Obama came, people were worried. It was a short-term exposure. So short-term exposure may not cause that much damage to normal healthy people. It may cause some discomfort. But a long-term exposure, yes. One. Two, short-term exposure in people who already have a blockage,
it may be a
problem. Then it can precipitate.
Yeah.
It can precipitate heart attack, it can precipitate paralysis. Now what does it does it? Now PM2.5 once absorbed will increase the vascular tone, will cause endothelial dysfunction, it will increase the plasma viscosity, and it can precipitate, it can cause autonomic dysfunction, and it can precipitate a heart attack and paralysis. Today, when patients come to me, and if they find their blood pressure is not getting controlled, I always look for at what level of pollution they are living.
Okay.
If just avoiding that can reduce pollution levels. Because second question they ask is, in the noise pollution, they can wear the plugs or muffs. What about air pollution? What do we do?
That's a big question, yes.
So now there's a huge market of air purifier. Whether they work or not, I don't know. But people are using air purifier, but that can only purify your room.
In a room, yes.
You can't use it in the car. Second thing
but
is...
But some car air purifiers are also available.
Second thing
and
is...
And do you think AC as such gives you some protection
it
against...
It depends upon which recirculating or with the air.
Okay.
It will depend upon that. If you're using external air is coming, then pollution levels are coming.
Okay.
I personally feel, keep your, measure your pollution level and then accordingly take a decision.
But sometimes, most of the times it may not be possible.
I am trying to, because right away I am coughing and the air pollution level is more than 100 and that's causing this.
What about the role of masks?
To some degree it may, we don't know. B is... Any voice cloth will definitely make you comfortable. Will definitely make you comfortable. We have no answer at the moment. The only answer is to reduce the pollution levels. At the moment is avoid the polluted area. Avoid the polluted area. Mm-hmm. Normally you say when there is a rain, don't go out. Similarly, there has to be a warning, don't go out. Now, in my, I have already put as an alert.
Okay.
So every few hours, I get an alert. What is the
level index?
Air pollution index. If I index, I get.
Yeah.
Then accordingly, I take a decision what to do, what not to do.
Any special precautions for senior citizens or children that you will advocate?
At the moment, be aware, reduce your pollution levels by making sure it has to be a collective approach. The whole colony has to decide.
Okay.
The whole colony has to decide. Now what is happening in US is they are allowing carpooling. So there is a separate row only for carpooling. So if you have more than 5 people in the car, then there is a special fast way for you. So some similar types of steps have to be taken. Then everywhere you will have to get your vehicle checked up. I personally have no answer. My answer is stay indoors. The pollution level is very high.
And do you think pollution levels are high when there is fog in the morning? And
see,
it is
pollution
no
level are high all the time.
Okay.
But when there is a fog, the particles get entangled into the fog and they become fog.
Yeah.
So they stay there. When they stay there, in winter you get many heart attacks. Precipitation of asthma.
Okay, it is not because of the low temperature, it is because of the...
No, because fog is because of low temperature.
Okay.
Fog, the pollution, the dissolvable impurities of the pollution will get entangled into water. They become smog.
Yeah.
Fog becomes smog. And they don't fly because once they are entangled, they cannot fly,
and
they cannot go off.
Temperature is low.
The temperature is low. Therefore, until the sun comes, there are more chances of asthma. Therefore, heart patients should not go out in smog.
And senior citizens also. I mean,
all people who are amenable and susceptible, they should not travel outdoor in this. So, now how to convert it into a? How to convert it into a ethical practice for a GP? So every GP should be able to get and download his. On his telephone.
App, well, this app on the telephone.
Okay.
Yeah.
This can become like a holder.
Okay.
A GP can charge money for that exercise. He can tell the patients that every hour, wherever you go, get your BP measured up and write down the PM 2.5 level.
Okay,
so in two days' time, you can find out whether the fluctuations in BP are related to 2.5 or not.
It can be so immediate.
Yes. Yes. So if that you can find out in patients, you will be able to give them a solution. Therefore, this becomes a 24-hour air condition tool for which you can charge. It's like a holter for which you can charge. And you can also, there are some doctors who don't tell people that this tool is available free of cost. So they will download it. They have 4 or 5 phones. They give their phone to them like a holder.
For 2-3 days.
So for 2-3 days, you measure it in this phone, which is fine. There's nothing wrong in it, which is ethical. So you should be able to measure your 24-hour pollution levels and the levels of your PEFR if you're asthmatic. So therefore a patient came to me from Daryaganj today. He's a COPD patient. He couldn't breathe. And in Daryaganj, the ABI was more than 300. Yes. So this is expected. So I have to end him. There was no other way than to give him steroids.
Okay.
So I added steroid. Otherwise, he will go into a catastrophe. So you know, suppose you cannot avoid pollution levels, then you know your requirement of doses are high. You have to keep them indoor. Okay, and such types of people can even choose. Why not? Suppose you are having a... See, Anand Vihar is talking about 500.
Mm-hmm.
There's no reason for an asthmatic patient to live in Anand Vihar today.
He should shift out.
Yeah.
Eh? He should shift out.
For a day or two, he can go out. For a day or two, he can go out.
But then you are going to have this weather in Delhi for the next 2 months at least.
596 doesn't matter.
This is critical. This is critical. I mean, this is
596, and even it is talking about. It is talking about is that R.K. Puram is unhealthy. It is also writing that New Delhi U.S. Embassy is unhealthy, and Anand Vihar is talking hazardous.
This is great. I mean, because I don't believe many doctors will know.
In Anand Vihar, it is talking PM 10 is 596, PM 2.5 is 256 for heart. And then it talks about NO2 is 42 and SO2 is 11. Therefore, if you only measure NO2 and SO2, you will say everything is fine. But NO2, SO2, we don't bother nowadays. For us, it is PM 2.5 and
particulate matter
2.5 and then in R.K. Puram is just the reverse. The PM 10 is 121 and PM 2.5 is 163. So in R.K. Puram, even the pollution level is 163, but chances of blood pressure are very high. So, you should be able to, I mean, there are hundreds, tens of such softwares available. You don't have to go to any site. You should be able to measure. And then you find out the nearest place where you live. So, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Delhi is divided into 5. You can go back to any city in the country and you should be able to measure.
But this is pretty critical. I mean, I believe that none of us, even doctors know the effects of pollution to that level. You know, you talk that they can have immediate effect on blood pressure, immediate attacks on your heart, and your respiratory system can be a failure.
Absolutely.
In these conditions.
Absolutely.
Oh God. And what is this National Green Tribunal doing? I mean, do you think any steps have been taken by the government?
I don't know, but
NGT?
I only know is that you can file a case against the government with a criminal offense to make your citizens suffer. If somebody really want to, 269, 270 or 550, a case can be filed.
It can be a PIL.
Yes, absolutely. And also remember, SO2 is linked with bronchitis and NO2 with asthma.
Okay.
I mean, there's slight difference between, that means NO2 levels will be in children, SO2 levels will be for adults.
Just we talked about children, you know, because in children you don't have a choice. They have to go to school early in the morning and, you know, all these hazardous areas.
I know. I would say that in 596 Anand Vihar,
don't let your children go to school.
I will close the schools.
Okay.
I will even ask the officers to shut down. How can you live? I mean, just in Anand Vihar, 596, how can you live in 596? I know day before yesterday, in some area, there was 800. Delhi has crossed 800 in many areas. And this is a local pollution.
Yeah.
It will be a local pollution. Pollution will vary from area to area. So at this moment, Anand Vihar is unlivable. At this moment.
Today I was looking at the TV. They said 34 times the normal value, and it is the same thing. You know, in fact, it's the same thing. 34 times the normal value.
You can talk to a couple of your friends if they are in Anand Vihar and find out how they are feeling.
Okay, but I think it's a lesson to be learned for all of us.
And why I did bring this issue is doctors are not using it to educate their patients. Okay. When you can charge a thermometer, when you take temperature, you charge. When you do a peak flow meter, you charge. Convert it into a
ethical
earning procedure. Ethical earning procedure. Up till now, the pollution meters were available for 60,000 rupees. You can buy a pollution measurement equipment,
small box,
which is 60,000 rupees available, indigenous, and American ones are 1.5 lakh. That is will give you the spot. This is not spot, this is an average.
Okay.
Those people who want to invest, they can buy that equipment for 60,000 rupees and the indigenous equipment, and that will give you the spot air pollution level at that particular moment. And that, if you charge 1,000 rupees for a patient like a Holter, you should be able to cover the cost in 2 months.
Are you linking it, you know, somewhere this pollution to cancer also?
See, 2.5, when it gets dissolved, it will cause all types of damage, kidney damage, cancer and everything. 10 will be associated with lung cancer, but 2.5 will get associated with every possible disease. Because the pollution is getting absorbed in the blood, and it is going to cause, it is linked with DVT, it is linked with pulmonary embolism, it is linked with Alzheimer's disease, practically every disease it is linked with. But the most important link where it has been proved is atherosclerosis.
Okay. That is why, I mean, you get so many cases, especially in winter, cardiac problems, early in the morning, person gets up, goes to the bathroom and has a chest pain.
So therefore, measure your pollution level and then decide by the dincharya, you must know your pollution level.
What
people
about
used to feel about what is the tide, high tide, low tide, humidity.
Coastal areas, they do it.
But measure pollution level also.
What is the significance of ozone effect? I mean, they talk about ozone.
They all are same, but then today ozone is also a damaging to the vessel wall and everything, but today we give importance to 2.5 and 10.
Okay.
I think if you have to find out one level, then it is 2.5 and 10.
Okay, you can see Dr. K.K. Agarwal, she was sitting in
pollution.
South Delhi, suffering from pollution effects of, rhinitis and all these things. She's not able to comfortably sit in the
zone. Because I don't have fever. No fever, no flu.
Yeah. And, especially these burning of these leaves and everything, I think that is also a cause.
Fossil fuel, other fuel, and then your vehicles, everything.
Okay.
Stove, everything produces pollution.
Okay.
Now let's go back to
I was reading somewhere that people say that even burning your agarbatti, your dhoop.
Fortunately, Ayurvedic herbs are harmless.
Okay.
So yagya, Ayurvedic, pure Ayurvedic smoking herbs are harmless to the body. So whatever is being used in a pure form in an havan, does not lead to pollution.
That's good. So friends, I mean, we talked about the air pollution, especially in the aftermath of Diwali and the cold season in Delhi and most of North India. And I think it is pretty critical. We must all be, you know, alert on this issue, and definitely advise our patients to be alert also. Now, I think, Dr. Agarwal, noise pollution is also a big issue.
Another source of income.
Yeah. We'll talk about it.
No,
but even in factories, industries,
no, again,
outside
again,
also.
Again.
Okay.
It has to be converted into a source of income.
Come on. Yes.
Okay. So again, there are, you don't have to buy any equipment.
Achha.
You just have to download a software. Okay.
Hmm.
For the benefit of people, I have downloaded two softwares.
Hmm.
Okay, I've done nothing. I've downloaded two softwares. There are at least tens of such softwares available.
Okay.
And you will measure the sound level through your phone.
Achha.
So you don't have to buy equipment. So let's say.
So this will be giving you exact reading of your room, of wherever you are.
That particular moment where you are.
Achha.
So at this moment, the sound level here is 100. No, let's see. It is. Approximately 90 to 100.
80 decibels.
At the moment, it is giving the value of 90 to 100.
Oh, that's a great one. I mean, that's a good diagram.
Okay. And then I go to another one. He says, he again says, when I speak, it becomes 90.
Obviously.
And when I'm in the silent zone, it is 70 to 80.
Okay.
70, and when I speak, it is crossing 90. 90, maximum 93, maximum 94 plus 1.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, I don't require anything. I require a software.
It's fast fluctuating when you talk.
Yes. Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, this tells us the decibel levels.
Oh, that's good.
Okay, again.
There's a graph.
Every
as well
10
as
rise of decibel is double the impact.
Okay.
So a 40 decibel versus 50, 50 is double, 60 is 4 times,
mm-hmm.
70 is 8 times, 80 is 16 times, 90 is 32 times the louder. So loudness has nothing to do with, it has to do with every 10 decibel. Here also 10. In both the positions.
Okay. But here you are doubling everything for everything.
Now let's see what is permissible level. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Then it is residential area.
Mm-hmm.
It should be 55 and 45. 55 in the morning, 45 in the night.
Okay.
That means,
but
this
now
building
yes.
cannot be the residential area.
That's right.
If you are going to live here, you are going to develop chronic sensory neural hearing loss, insomnia, blood pressure and other things. So in a residential area, it has to be 55 and 45. In a commercial area, it has to be 65 in daytime and 55 in nighttime. It is crossing that.
Yeah.
When I am talking, it is crossing 65. So this is not a true commercial area. In an industrial area, it is 75 in daytime and 70 in night time.
Mm-hmm.
This is the industrial area. Is it industrial area?
No.
Commercial area.
Shopping area.
So there is no industry here. So at any given time, it is 65 in daytime and 55 in night time. So whenever I am speaking, it is increasing. Now let's see. Let's understand that. Anything more than 120 can cause hearing loss.
Okay. And in a place like Delhi or
Kolkata. Let's see. Normal conversation is 60.
Okay.
When I talk, it should make it 60, but it is making 90. That means?
Base level is high.
So base level is high. That means AC levels are high and the other sounds near the road levels are high. So the normal conversation should give me 60. But it is crossing 90 at the moment. Then any sound above 85 is harmful. So for me, formula of 80. Again.
Yes. 80 is safe. 80 is safe. Onwards is unsafe.
Anything less than 80 is fine. More than 80 is harmful with that. Now what happens is, at 90 decibel, say for this atmosphere of 90, here it is crossing 90, my maximum work limit should be 8 hours.
Okay.
They have defined.
Chika.
They have defined from the purpose. Then for 95, it is 4 hours. For 100, it is 2 hours. For 105, it is 1 hour. For 110, it is 1 hour. 115, it is half an hour. And 120 is 15 minutes. If I sit more than that, my ear will get damaged.
Alarming. Okay.
So therefore, if I have to work on Saturday, Sunday, I better work for my residence than to come here and work.
What it will cause is,
it will ultimately lead to sensory neural
damage
to the nerve of the, and your hearing will get impaired.
Mm-hmm.
And in the city of Delhi, there are LNJP reports available that 70-80% of us have some hearing loss because of chronic noise pollution.
Okay.
So nobody's measuring. Plus it will cause irritation, insomnia and high blood pressure.
Yeah.
So those people who are, blood pressure is not getting controlled, look for PM2.5, look for the decibel levels. Just measure it and find out what the normal level is.
Mm-hmm.
Now there is a silent zone. Silent zone means zones around 100 meters, the levels should be 50 and 40, less than 50.
Mm-hmm.
In silent zone. That means hospitals, schools, and courts. They are called silent zones. Silent zone means within 100 meter radius, you do not allow.
Yeah.
Now, what is causing the noise pollution? A, if there are 40 people working in this office, all of them are on mobile.
Yes.
So their noise level comes.
Hmm.
At any given time, somebody is talking. That is producing noise in the atmosphere. If all 40 of them are talking, they all noise vibrations gets collected together.
Yeah.
AC you are using.
Coolers or water
coolers you are using.
Mm.
And near the road.
Mm.
Near the road. Now there are studies available. They say that for those people who are living near the airport, and in the night time, if the plane is going from their roof, crossing the roof every hour or every 1 hour, their blood pressure is higher there. If they live there versus if they don't live there. Plus, if your house is on the road, main road, your blood pressure will be higher.
Mm-hmm.
If your schools are on the main road, your blood pressure will be higher. So practically, 100 meters all around the hospitals. Now today you say what says, we should buy a plot which is absolutely on the main road for a hospital.
Yeah.
The answer is no.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot. So hospital, courts, hospital and medical institutions and school institutions are made inside so that the pollution level is the
minimum there. It can be minimized.
And we are on the contrary. We say we want to buy. We are fighting that we want to buy nursing homes on the... And the government's policy is allowing nursing homes on the wider road when it should be reversed.
Yeah, sure.
But
there are not many options available in places.
Whether
like
it is
there
clear
or
not, question is, what is scientific?
Yeah.
It is very clear that all of us should... See, I am talking to NDMC chairman, that why can't we come out with a colony? Which is ideal.
Hmm.
Can we come out with an experiment? Say, when you want to buy a house, what should you look for? All of us look for a vastu. I said look for medical vastu.
Okay.
Instead of measuring north, east, south, west, measure 2.5.
And proximity.
That is vastu.
And proximity to the traffic.
No. And dB levels.
Mm.
I don't care.
dB levels, yeah.
I want dB levels.
Mm.
I want this. I want lead levels in water. I want dissolved impurities in water. Okay.
Okay.
I want to see the level of water there. Mm. Is it deep enough or superficial? And that should decide my rate. And I should see whether the sunlight is coming. Am I getting vitamin D or not?
Sure.
So if I'm getting vitamin D, if my water levels are on high enough, if my particulate matter is more less than is the residential area is around 50-60, if my noise pollution levels are within range, in that particular area,
that's a perfect place to.
That is the area where I should be able to pay extra. That should decide the cost of a building, not the area.
Not your proximity to
medical. That is my medical vastu. As you have a medical janam patri, this is my medical vastu. This is how I am going to decide that I am getting enough sunlight, my water is pure here, my water is 24 hours here. Okay, my radiation levels, we will talk about, one more day we will talk about radiations. That also we are doing a study and measuring them. So my radiation levels should be within permissible limit. Okay, so if I do that, then my soil doesn't have any, my soil is healthy, my water is healthy, my air is healthy, my space is healthy, my fire is healthy. If I do that, that will be an ideal place to live.
Okay. Even I believe pollution control boards of the government, except for the generator,
there are decibels. There are guidelines for everything.
Yeah.
For guidelines for your generator, cooler, AC. There are guidelines available, but how many of us actually get it measured like a car? We go for a car pollution checkup. So do we? We should. Now, where we buy a air conditioner, we look for cost. We don't look for the noise level. So what we will do is, we will save 5,000 rupees for an air conditioner, but buy an 10 extra dB noise levels.
Okay. So, for example, a split unit will cost more, but it will cost lesser.
With a lesser decibel levels.
Window AC will cost less.
Less, but with a higher decibel levels.
Okay. I mean, that's also a thing to be learned by all of us.
Absolutely. So, therefore, I want to take whatever equipment I'm buying. I need to check my washing machine, how much decibel sound it is producing. You are buying a second-hand car, if it gives you noise, you are in trouble.
So
it is linked with, now noise pollution is now identified. Now if you see the Supreme Court judgment which came in one of the laboratories,
they did
consider about the noise pollution. They said if your instrument is causing noise pollution to the neighbors, it needs to be closed. So up till now, I know I had an instrument which I purchased it from US, and that I used to measure the decibel levels, but I don't need to do it now. Now I can get it on the right. It's so simple that at any given time, see, again, it is, see, let's close our voice. So it is 63, 64, 70. That means it is equivalent to as if we are talking.
Yeah.
Conversation is 65. So therefore the background noise is high.
Yeah.
And therefore it is crossing 90 when we talk. So the peak is 93. 96 maximum has gone. See, hello! See, it crossed 101.
101. But just believe, I mean, think about these marriages, programs and all
DJ,
Ohala, DJ yes. and everything.
See, it's okay.
That must
How
be
will you come to know? What are the tricks available? So if I am talking to you, and if I have to go nearer you to listen, it is damaging to the ear. That's the first formula. That you should be able to converse with another person without making an effort. If you are making an effort, it means the noise levels are more than normal and go out. Go out. Okay, so when you go to a party, there are 500 people in a small area and you are not being able to talk to each other.
Yeah.
That's the hazard. Second, if you have an ear pain while talking, immediately go out. Don't wait.
Okay.
And third thing is, when you leave the place for a few minutes, if your hearing is impaired, like it happens in the airplane.
Tingling sensation or...
if you have an tinnitus type of a feeling, immediately leave that place, immediately. And it's easier it's very good to use that. When you go to an area, you have the
cotton plugs.
Not cotton, the plugs are available now. Plugs EM plugs and EM muffins are available in the market.
Okay.
They are solely available. Keep them in your car and we are done.
Mm-hmm.
And then next comes is that when you hear a suppose I want to put it into the ear and want to listen to the music.
Okay.
So then again, 2 hours and less than 50% of the volume.
Yeah,
it should not be more than 50% of the value, never more than 80% of the value, and less than 2 hours a day. Otherwise, you use the earphones.
Okay, it's quite trendy nowadays to use earphones for all your functions. So that can be still bad.
No, but then you can use earphones with that.
Yeah.
So the message is that we have 2 instruments available on your mobile, which can measure your noise level and air pollution level. So you can measure your API, that is air pollution index, and you can measure your sound levels.
Decibels.
When you start using this in your practice, you will remember the figures, and they can make a difference in irritation, insomnia, sleeping disorders, blood pressure, uncontrolled blood pressure,
nervousness,
irritability.
So
somebody is irritable, you can get an excuse and say, boss, I am irritable only because of PM is...
People used to say only because of heat, now people can say
heat
of pollution.
Heat and humidity, then rise and low and high tides, and now we are talking about PM 2.5, PM 10, and we are talking about dB levels. So with this you should be able to measure and help your patients and earn more. Again, I'm coming to, because you can use them as a holter, noise holter, and you can call them as air pollution holter, and you should be able to convert it into your practice gains. You are saving somebody's life. You should be converted into, you are giving them an advice. So when we were there in MBBS, this was not taught to us because the equipments were not available to us.
And maybe the noise was also not that much at that time.
A year back, even I was not using it extensively because I had to buy an instrument. An instrument I cannot lend to a patient. I cannot use it for more than one patient. But now every patient has a smartphone.
In his own hand.
In his own hand. And he can measure the levels. Absolutely.
So, KK, the carry-home message is to take care of your pollution, the surroundings pollution levels, as well as the decibel levels. And that can be done by yourself using your Android phones
and
learning.
And also a software which I haven't downloaded. It also gives you a warning.
Okay.
It also
that will
gives
give
you,
a, make you alert.
It makes you alert. You will leave the place immediately.
Okay.
That will tell you don't stay here. So sooner or later, a personalized meter will come, software will come, where you have to fit down your age.
Okay.
You put down your high blood pressure, you are about hypertension, diabetic, you put down your parameters and it will give you an alert. Leave this place immediately.
That's good. That's very good.
That is going to come, and then asthmatic, COPD, they will tell you that leave this area immediately, like a horn. So if your car is moving, they will say, don't stay here.
But looking at the conditions in Delhi, I think it will not even allow you to stay in Delhi
at least, because right away you are seeing. I'll give you an answer for that. See, at this particular moment, it has now become, Anand Vihar has become 418 from 600. US Embassy is 184. RK Puram is 176. But civil lines, at this moment, they say there is no pollution.
Okay.
So at this moment, the civil lines is coming good.
Okay.
And the levels are less than 50. SO2 is 6, NO2 is 10.
Maybe because most of the colleges are closed today, universities
no.
closed
question
today.
Is not that.
Question is,
to eat Golgappa, we have to go. What is civil line?
Civil lines. The good Golgappas there.
This is what I meant to say. At this moment, if you want to have a party, go to civil lines. There are hotels there. So when you go out and you decide where to meet, suppose you have to meet your friend, you go there and find out. I says, he says, let's meet in Anand Vihar. Sorry. He says, let's meet in civil lines.
Yeah.
So you will spend 3 hours there. Mm-hmm. You will, by the time Anand Vihar may become.
That's right.
That's what I think.
I think just like people talk about the weather, just about the snow conditions.
And in this software, you can put down, otherwise you go to DPCC site.
Okay.
Delhi Pollution Control Board site. And there also you get accurate results.
Good. I think we have gained a lot. At least I have gained a lot from Dr. K.K. Agarwal today by looking at these two sites. And I'm sure you must have seen that in your own areas, there are so much of pollution levels or so much of noise levels. And with this, we should be more intelligent on this issue. And we can give this guidance and make our patients also more comfortable in their life and avoid these complications, neurological, heart, and chest, and all these problems. I think any more message you want to give finally?
Nothing. I have only said is that we have given you two more new parameters, normally not taught to us during MBBS. I'm sure that you will need to see this video again and again. So go back to our IMA website. We also have a youtube.com/Indian Medical Association where all the videos are there. And I think that this is something which will not only help you, it will also help in your practice. And that's what the purpose of IMA is, to bring to you low-cost modules which can make you earn more money ethically and also help the patients. I personally feel these two parameters. These two parameters should be used. So you must have a thermometer, you must have an inchi tape. We'll talk someday for an hour on inchi tape, how inchi tape helps you in your practice. You must have peak flow meters, you must have a SaO2 meter, and then you must have a software for PM2.5 and a software for the sound levels. And if you do that, your real practice will change. And all these parameters should be, your attendant outside can fill up these parameters, and by the time patient comes to you, it may be able to help you in your clinical practice. And that's all for today. We thank Dr. Monga for moderating this session. And we'll come back next Thursday with another topic. And we may be bringing association presidents from next time so that we can interact on various subjects. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Agarwal. Thank you.